Hello. I've got some machinist jobs to do, and then once they're done, I'm gonna queue for Susanna. I moved on to this once I got my summoner to 50. The issue being that this is actually like the last one now. I don't have any more DPS classes after this. I don't know what to do. So I found out the other day that apparently when you finish the the hunting log, the grand companies, apparently they give you a minion, and I'm sure I did for the other one, but I didn't get a minion. What quest is this for? Clearly not this quest. Thank you. I've been playing a lot of Samurai recently as well, and I've been quite enjoying it. No, like, recently I've not really had time to do much. So what I mean is that I've been, like, just focusing on getting the main story done. I've been doing the job quests as well, but, like, besides these two things, like, I've just been doing main story. Because I'm trying to see if I can get to Endwalker, like, on release. And to do that, I need to do 7 main story quests a day. Like, currently I'm on track to be able to do it. But because of that, I've not been doing any side quests at all. So I've unlocked, like, very low. I've still got side quests from Heavenswood to do. Yeah, we talked about that when it happened. I think we were trying to work out if that was the first time that we'd, like, actually lost a fight. Because we were saying that there's times when, like, enemies have run away from us, or times when, like, we've run away, stuff like that. But I don't think there was, like, a time when we actually just strictly lost a fight to them. That is a terrible name. Surely he must be cold wearing that shirt. Right. Now we can queue for Susano. And guess we'll do more phone requests while we wait. Oh, that's what that one was for, okay. What? Oh. Okay, I didn't even see that. Why are you even here, then? I like it when the cloth just clips through it. Really adds to the realism, it's great. Just on all of them. My issue isn't that it happens at all, because especially when you're making something of this scale, obviously everything takes time and it's work. Like, I understand. It's purely an issue where when it's like practically focused on by the camera in a cutscene, you'd want that fixed, surely. Like, I understand not prioritizing it at all times, but sometimes you should, surely. This is going to be a really long queue, isn't it? All right, thanks for coming. He's wearing one as a hat. It's been 17 minutes already. I'm quite literally a cat person. I want a cat minion. on, last DPS, please. Oh, for fuck's sake. Why queue for so long if you're just going to quit at the end? That's a bit different.
Resilient souls, I salute you! Earth and stone at our beck and call!
went like really well. It's the first time in a while where we've done a trial and not died on one attempt.
Nary a peep from the shellbacks, sir. It's enough to make one wonder.
The Red have sounded the alarm. The Isle of Zetki under attack. Fierce fighting in the stronghold. The vault breached by outsiders and strange tales from deep within. All this the Red cannot ignore. Even now, they abandon their posts and flock to the Isle. The Garleans are powerless to stop them.
I'll be damned, they did it. Well, Captain, wagers notwithstanding, I dare say we will not have a better opportunity to drive the Imperials from Asari and rescue our men. On the other hand, naught was put in writing, but if your mind is made up, then that is that. I should add that if you were to change your mind, none would gainsay your decision, nor think you beholden to your past. Nor would anyone begrudge you a spot of revenge into the bargain. Like the little miss said, we knew this day would come.
Isari may be a rotting husk, but at least the tavern keeper never watered down his drinks.
Well said. For a temperate man.
Hear me, comrades! We made a bargain with the Eorzeans, and I mean to uphold our end of it. I mean to remind the Garleans that this is our sea, that all here belongs to the Confederacy. All that is theirs is ours for the taking, and take it we shall. We will strip them of everything they hold dear.
This one is iron. My hands will break before he speaks.
Oh, come, he give me strength. Are you good at anything? I had hoped this might prove more productive than blind inquiries, but I see you are determined to waste my time. Very well. Line them up. Kill one for every question he refuses to answer.
Hurt them, and you will get naught from me.
You have given me precisely that thus far, so what have I to lose? Mark me, samurai. I will find Lord Hien, be it with your help or with your heads.
Scum! You will pay for that!
Confederacy. They've come to save us!
And this after I took such pains to cow them. Even pirates have their pride, I suppose. Enough to march to their deaths, no less. Oh, the stupidity of it all. It truly is a sickness. I shall just have to lance the boil. Drain them of every last trace of honor and compassion. Every last drop.
My lady, I'm going outside. Kami are not finished with you yet.
There's no end to them. They just keep coming.
Then we must be doing something right. We have to hold out for as long as we can. He's counting on us.
Oh. Susano is slain! Slain by the Shellless One!
True. Did you defeat him? Well, in that case, how do you fancy helping us keep the Kojin occupied until the Confederacy make their move? Speak of the devils, that's coming from Isari.
I think we've done all we can here. Let's withdraw and make for the village.
Right. Although, they don't seem keen to let us go.
Hear me, Kojin of the Red. We have no quarrel with you, only your Imperial Masters. No more blood need be shed this day. I pray you let us go in peace.
You dare speak to us of peace? Your flesh will feed the fishes, thief! Attack!
Now's our chance. Don't worry about her, she can handle herself.
Oh.
can't let you take all the glory, can I?
I've got a monk job quest to do. I completely forgot. We could have just all escaped and then none of us would have to go back. Me.
Yeah.
my Eorzean friends. Saw the smoke, did you? A pity you did not come sooner, though I gather you were busy elsewhere.
Gusetsu! You're alive. You're all alive.
And full of vim and vigor.
Did I not tell you I was no stranger to chains?
The fighting cannot have lasted long. Where are all the Imperials?
Fled. They stood their ground for a time, until it became clear that their Korjin reinforcements would not be coming. We took some few casualties, but my deeper regret is having let Yotsuyu slip through my fingers. That bodyguard of hers may be a halfwit, but he's a mean bastard on the battlefield.
In any event, I imagine all involved are satisfied with this outcome. So far as the Empire is concerned, the Confederacy attacked Asari in retaliation for the Viceroy's actions. And without the aid of insurrectionists, I might add. Suffice it to say, we are prepared to be the subject of their undivided attention for the foreseeable future.
An impossible claim, yet one spoken with such conviction that I cannot choose but believe it.
Your assistance would be most welcome. Nevertheless, we shall do our utmost to spare you undue danger. We are already in your debt.
Nay, little miss, all debts are paid. For by your deeds, many still live who elsewise would not. Let both parties count their blessings, and may fortune continue to favor us all.
You still seek to bring freedom to our people, then? You will go to Yansha?
I have faith that our allies yet live. Once we have found them, we will plan our next step.
Yansha was the crucible of the rebellion. What happened here pales in comparison to what Yotsuyo did there. Remember this. Fear changes men. Have care in whom you place your trust.
And with that, we must take our wounded home. Oh, your shellback friend sends his regards and looks forward to your next meeting. Try not to die before then, eh?
I want one of their masks. I like them. That's the second time we've had that title card in like 10 minutes.
We cannot rest here for long. This place is not safe. Mayhap nowhere is, if thieves can breach our vaults. Nevertheless, it is our duty to protect these treasures, and we shall not fail for want of effort.
So, this is why you abandoned your posts, and without a word of explanation at that. Rather thoughtless of you, was it not?
Lady Yotsuyo, pray forgive us our absence, but our home was under attack, our vaults plundered by outsiders.
Did you even pause to consider the possibility that it might be a diversion? What is the point of contracting your services if you are not here when they are required? It is my solemn charge to bring these vermin to heel. To torment them, body and soul, until all they hold dear is as bitter ashes in their mouth. And then you go and ruin everything! Well, there's naught to be gained in belaboring the point. All that remains is to administer your punishment.
Wait, my lady!
No. No, it's no good. There's just no joy in it. Release. There needs to be some investment. There were negligent imbeciles deserving of punishment, but it was hardly personal. 10,000 such caution could not satisfy me half so well as a single doma. One of the vaunted treasures of the Red? The craftsmanship is certainly impressive. Mayhap we can use it to make amends.
How long before Lord Xenos reinstates me, do you reckon? I've got unfinished business back in Eorzea.
Is serving me really so unbearable? At least pretend to enjoy, you witless lump! If you are so desperate to earn a way back to Eorzea, then be quiet and do as you're told. And bring that sword while you're at it.
I remember the silence, how the talking stopped when we first set foot on the plains of Yansha. Before us stood yet another wall, and through a great Magitek field we glimpsed Doma Castle. I'll never forget the sight, or the anger I felt that day. Life, liberty, hope, so much lost, so much taken. As we walked through that war-torn land, no one said a word.
We may be in luck. I don't see a single Imperial soldier.
Then there is no need to remain hidden. Let us go and greet them as friends.
I'm going too.
People of Namai, hearken to me. We come in peace and desire only information to learn of recent events.
Isn't that the general?
Lord Gorsetsu, can we preserve your right? He lives.
I say, brothers and sisters, is aught amiss? Why do you regard me as one with a wild beast? Why is there fear in your eyes? Why do you tremble so? Ah, but of course, you fear me, a vengeful spirit of the dead. Rest assured, naught could be further from the truth. For am I not corporeal? Are my feet not firmly set upon the ground?
What should we do? If they catch him here, you know what will happen.
Of all the times for him to turn up. Has the old fool lost his mind?
Come here. What do you want from us?
I know not who you are to speak thus to your elders, boy, but mine only desire is to be received with the hospitality owed a humble traveler, not the fear and trepidation one might afford a wrathful shade.
What? What are you going on about? Actually, never mind. Just come with me. Now!
This is the House of the Fierce. But there are so few of them.
Many kindred spirits remain in hiding following the rebellion. Many others gave their lives for their nation. We are a stubborn remainder. Even accounting for our comrades in the field, we are at a fraction of our former strength, 'tis true. Yet we few are patriots. Brothers in arms, prepared to fight with every fiber of our being to set our people free.
Ever are we hopeful that others will join our cause, but never did I dream that you would journey so far.
Yugiri! Gods, it's good to see you. You look great, by the way. Have you been here long?
I returned but recently, having concluded my mission. Oh, it is good to see you again, my friends.
Did I hear aright? Your mission is concluded? Then you have found the young master.
Ere we speak of that, I would know by what fortuitous circumstance our friends came to be here. The Empire's crimes are all too familiar. Lys, my heart goes out to your people.
We wanted to stay and fight, believe me, but we knew it wouldn't work. We needed more time to rebuild, and more allies to stand with us against the Empire. So we decided to come here and help you free Doma, to show you, to show everyone that you're not alone, and that the Garleans can be beaten if we work together. I'd like to think we proved that in the Ruby Sea.
That you did, Lys, and far more besides. Needless to say, your assistance would be most welcome.
Hear, hear. Now then, Yugiri, you must tell me of your search for our master.
Lest you wonder, he speaks of Lord Hien, son of Lord Kaien, who perished during the rebellion. When it became clear that all hope of victory had gone, Lord Hien bade us deliver as many of our people as we could to safety beyond our borders. But as his father's heir, he was determined to fight on, and so he did, until he suffered a grievous wound in battle and vanished without a trace. Until now. For I have found Lord Hien, seen and spoken with him, on the Azim Steppe.
Oh, boundless and merciful Kami, the young master lives. Tell me, was he well? Did his wound yet ail him? Where is he now? Have you brought him back to us?
You may take comfort in the knowledge that he is hale and whole. However, when I invited him to return with me to Doma, he had this to say. If Doma yet thirsts for the blood of patriots and tyrants, I shall offer unto her my blade. But if she has had her fill of bitter draughts, I shall offer unto her conquerors my head. Thrice did I declare to him that no true son or daughter of Doma would ever accept such a sacrifice. But for all my passion, he would not be swayed. Learn the truth of her heart and return to me, he said. And so I left him.
Words of one made to wear the mantle of leadership too soon. Yet there is wisdom in them all the same. If the people no longer yearn to be free, it would be folly to rekindle the fires of war.
To suffer our master, to surrender his life and forsake all hope of freedom is by far the greater folly. I will not go to face my fallen comrades having done naught to stop it.
Nor I, Shadow Walker, nor I. But we need not rouse our comrades to battle this day. Let us instead welcome our honored guests and allow them a moment of respite.
Yeah, I'm gonna have, like, so many seals eventually. I got my rank up a little bit as well. I'm a first class now. I feel like this plan would work better if we hadn't already been to the town. Didn't know there were fairies. Well, I suppose they did. They're cat people. Well, you know what I mean. We're finally getting to the actually better gear. Taken forever, but we're getting there. I've just thought. So, I've got all this shit, like the blue stuff. I've got loads of it that I need to put away. But I can't do it because I can't buy any glamour crystals. Because I'm not high enough rank in the Grand Company yet. It'd clear some space if I could. No, I just need seals. I need more seals to rank up so that I can get to the point where I can trade in stuff for seals. And then it will be fixed.
Imperials.
I should have bought a load before I switched companies.
Like a pack of slack-jawed mongrels. Form a line! Now! Finally. I come before you today to deliver an announcement of the highest import. So listen well. While on a charitable mission to Isari Village, the acting Viceroy and her personal guard came under attack from Confederate forces. This brazen, unconscionable act cannot and will not go unanswered. As loyal subjects of the Empire who enjoy her safety and prosperity, you have a duty to defend her as well. There is no cause for alarm. We have no intention of sending ill-trained fodder to the front line. Those who are selected will be expected to perform rudimentary tasks, cleaning and maintenance and so forth. You will serve only as long as you are needed. Afterwards, you'll be free to return to your homes. You first.
The Empire has no pressing need of cleaners. This is but a thinly veiled attempt to intimidate those who supported the Confederacy's actions, and isolate any whose loyalty they already suspect.
And lastly, you. That should suffice for now.
Don't worry. I will be back before you know it. Listen to the elders while I'm away, and do not play outside the village. Everything is going to be fine. I love you, all right? Remember that I love you.
We thank you for your cooperation. Rest assured that this will all be over very soon, once the Confederacy has been made to pay our own ruby tithe.
There's no telling what might happen to those people. We have to help them.
And we shall. But before all else, we must needs ascertain their destination. I doubt this is the first village the Garleans have visited, nor is it like to be the last. I will track these men. Will you help me? Pray return to our headquarters and tell the others what you saw here. Should we have need of reinforcements, I would know that they are ready.
But I should be going with you. I came here to fight!
Soon enough, Lys. Soon enough. For now, we must proceed with caution.
I know that. I do. It's just... when I saw them rounding those people up... Look, if anything happens, anything at all, you'd better call for us. I mean it, Yugiri. Anything at all.
I'm surprised they let the fairies live at all, to be honest. It just doesn't seem in keeping with their character. The music here is very cheerful considering everything that's going on. What is this? So were they just like playing too much of the sniper games when they were making this expansion? Just decided they had to include it? What the fuck is that? I can't believe I missed. I'm gonna get to 66 today as well, aren't I? Going through levels so quickly. Thank you. I feel weird about this. Because, like, I understand that we don't want him to be essentially taken into slavery. Like, I can agree with that. But at the same time, if we free them, we're, like, dooming all of their villages. And I don't know which of those sounds like the better option right now. I was hoping there'd be a shortened form of it.
Listen to me, all of you. We have dealt with the Imperials for now, but you must flee this place quickly.
So here's my point, though. Where are they supposed to go?
Dealt with them? Oh, no. You didn't kill them, did you?
Are you mad? There's no escaping the Empire. Running will only make it worse.
To stay is to die. You know this to be true. Even if you lack the will to fight, surely you have the will to live! Or has that, too, been beaten out of you? Is this what has become of Doma?
You were Lord Heian's retainer, trained to fight without fear and obey without question. Well, we're not. We're lost and afraid. We hate this, all of this, but we can't do a damn thing to change it, and trying will only make it worse. It's a pathetic existence, but it's all we got. And when people like you come here pretending it can be different, it doesn't help, all right?
Peace, boy. Peace. She came to help, and for that we should be grateful.
Elder, your face.
We all have scars. Some too many to bear. Too many battles. Too much lost. Our friends, our family, even our liege. We who survived are forced to bend the knee, to sell our souls and surrender our dignity. How are we to lift our heads when this shame weighs so heavily upon us? Your courage, your resolve, they are as salt in our wounds.
They only knew what you would do for them, my lord. You have made your plight clear, and I shall impose my will no more. But know this, brothers and sisters of Doma. For all you have suffered, for all the horror and the ignominy, you are still here. You are still alive. My lord prays you value your life as highly as he does. As for me, I swear by all the Kami in creation that I will free you from this torment, no matter the cost.
If the Imperials come for me, I will tell them we were tricked by an Ori woman.
Tell them whatever you must, to keep your loved ones safe.
Why would you... After everything.
Oh, nice. A new tackle. Get to use that for like 2 months. Did I just pick him up? Is he just in my bag? Yes, he's just in my bag.
Forgive me for making you search. It calms me, the sound. It helps me to remember the sway of the ocean when I close my eyes. Despite the many great and noble things I said, in truth, I am not of Doma. I was born beneath the waves of the Ruby Sea.
Yeah, we met your parents.
To think that you were there, that you even spoke with my mother and father. They are in good health, then. The knowledge is of great comfort to me. That I might have the strength to protect my home from the Empire, I left to learn the secrets of the Shinobi. Day and night we trained, ever striving to exceed our mental and physical limits. After a time, my skills were recognized, and I was dispatched to assist the Doman Liberation Front. It was then that I met Lord Kayan and his son, and their loyal samurai, Gosetsu. Good men all, brave and true, so clear their eyes, so pure their purpose. Any shinobi would have been proud to serve them and Doma. But, in the end, I will always be of the sea. Every day, I pray for my home and for the people I left behind, that they might be spared the wages of war and live in peace, untouched by this madness. I confessed this to Lord Hien once. Do you know what he said to me? He said, good. We are better for the conviction of our allies and draw inspiration from their example. What is weak alone may together grow stronger. Never did I lose faith in them. Even when all was lost and I led our people to Eorzea, I clung to the belief that our dream would one day be realized. But when I gazed into those eyes bereft of hope, when those broken men balked at liberty, the dream was shattered. That you remain resolute, even in the face of everything we have seen, it heartens me more than you know. Thank you for standing by this naive fool. An Imperial airship. It is bound for Doma Castle. Quickly, we must rejoin the others.
I like to imagine that I'm just thinking about punching the ship. Like, I can't actually do anything, but I feel like that'd be my reaction. Do you think if Konami and Kohagi had a child that they'd make Castlevania games?
We spied an airship bound for the castle. Know you aught of it?
Aye, that we do. The Crown Prince is come to Doma.
We suspect this is a result of recent events in Girabania. Our defeat notwithstanding, there appears to be some concern in Garlemald that subversive elements may be rallying in other provinces. Though Yotsuyu governs Doma, Xenos remains the province's anointed viceroy, and it would seem he has come to assess the current situation in person.
If Xenos is here, we must seize this opportunity and kill him.
Would that it were so simple, Lady Yugiri. You may recall that we encountered Xenos at Rolga's Reach. We have seen firsthand what he can do. His power defies explanation. He faced the Alliance, the Resistance, and the Scions, and he defeated us all. We survived and learned from the experience, it is true. But if we are to defeat him, it will not be through simple opportunism. We will require a flawless plan.
We know his strengths. A prodigious swordsman trained from childhood by the finest Imperial tutors, reputed to be without equal on the battlefield, which is why we must not meet him there. Nay, we keep to the shadows, the domain of the Shinobi, and thence we strike. You need only give me the chance.
Were this but a matter of personal revenge, I would not presume to bar your path, for I myself crave that same vengeance. But to draw steel against the Emperor's son is a grave decision, and one that will shape our nation's future. Do not forget Lord Hien's words.
What, that we should sheathe our swords if the people lack the will to fight? I will not squander this opportunity. If we do naught, our master's life is forfeit.
Even should you succeed, Xenos' death will not win Doma her freedom. More likely, her doom. Can we defend our people against the Empire's retribution? We few against a legion? Do not be a fool, child!
Mayhap I am a fool with foolish dreams of a future that will never be. But I cannot, I will not forsake them!
Yugiri, wait!
What now?
Well, she can't assassinate him if I punch him first. I'm not going to do that now, because I'm going to end in about 6 minutes, but I might try and do this monk quest. And then I'll stop after that. I think this takes me to 10 story quests done today, which is good. We're still slightly ahead of track, which is nice. been so long since I've been here. I'm just thinking, I could probably get rid of a load of shit on the bottom bar now that I'm not using this to do like lower level stuff. Because I'm not going to run dungeons as this if I'm using it to do all the story and that. So like, I have no need to keep Fists of Earth and Fists of Wind on. I don't think I've ever used Fists of Wind, to be honest. I don't think I've used it even once. Maybe I will next time I unlock something new. It's supposed to make you slightly faster. It just increases your movement speed. But I've, like, never used it. Because Fist of Earth increased your defense, and then Fist of Fire increases your damage. So I can understand using either of those. But this one just makes you move faster. I've, like, never seen the use of it. Maybe, but like then you've got to like switch to it anyway. I'll just... Right. So here's... I'm on fire right now. That's the switch to wind. And then that's the switch back to fire. I think... Yeah, you can still move and stuff while switching. But like... It doesn't feel noticeably faster. Like, maybe a tiny bit. Okay, yeah, a little bit. I don't know, it just... It has never felt worth it. I could maybe understand just having it on if you're like running around places. But I would just get my mount out if I'm moving around. You know, like, in the very brief window early in the game where you don't have a mount, I could understand. But you don't even unlock it till 34. So you'd have a mount by that point. Oh, it's the fake griffin. Well, he's wearing the same clothes at least. Just going to be Ilbert again. Like, I want, like, random characters to just turn out to be Ilbert over and over again, and it, for it to, like, never make sense. was a while ago now, but do you remember the other day when we were in a cutscene towards the end of Heavenswood and I asked if, like, something, like, flickered on the screen? So, like, I've since worked out why it is, and it's something to do with the shadows. Like, every now and again in a scene, the scene will start, and then the shadows will, like, flicker and move. And they move, like, out of position then back in, and that's what I was seeing. So the issue is that it happens so quickly that it shows up on my screen, but not in either the recording or the stream, because of the difference in the frame rate. It just happened again a minute ago, which is what reminded me. Right, that's enough for today then. So, gold saucer. Plan for tomorrow is do more quests. That's it. I'm still ahead, which is good. Less ahead today than I was on Friday, if that makes sense. I did 12 on Friday, but only 10 today. But I also had to spend how long did it take? 20? Nearly 30 minutes queuing for that Susanna at the start? But anyway, that's done now. And I think there's something like 12 quests left until the next dungeon. So we might, if we're lucky, get through all of those tomorrow. And then be able to do that on Wednesday. Speaking of Wednesday, I have to finish early on Wednesday. So I know for a fact I'm going to get less done then. But hopefully we'll get at least one thing done. Right. Well, thanks for coming. I'll see you later. Bye.